When others try to rain on your dreams, just carry an umbrella and dream on. This is what I literally did. But when I speak of umbrellas, I don't speak of the boring black umbrellas that protest against the rain gods, nor do I speak about the floral umbrellas that your aunt used back in the 1940s. I speak about umbrellas with colorful doodles of vada pav, of chai, of barish, of traffic, of music, of everything that connects us to the rains. So when I was out of college, I thought it was a good time to make it happen. But when people around me asked me, "So bro, what are your plans after college? What do you want to do ahead in life?" And I replied, "I think I want to sell umbrellas." All I got were awkward glances or cynical chuckles. I mean, no one took me seriously because I wasn't developing the next big app or co-founding a hyperlocal delivery startup. Who sells umbrellas after 22 years of education? Not many. But I was always of the opinion that it is lateral thinking and unique ideas that make people successful and not just good grades. So when others around me searched for jobs to lead a secure life, I was hustling throughout the city with nothing but a minimal capital and a bright idea that needed execution. The funny thing is that I didn't know anything about umbrellas or designing or marketing or manufacturing. Hence, I approached this idea like climbing the Everest. I couldn't see the peak, but I always knew what the next step would be like. So I got in touch with a designer who translated my vision on paper. I hustled throughout the city until I found someone who could manufacture my product. And before I knew it, all of my life savings were invested in a couple of umbrellas. I was as excited as a father would be on the birth of his first child. But that is when catastrophe struck. I realized that whatever you do in life, there will always be things that are not in your control. And these things could ultimately determine your success or failure. 90% of the umbrellas that were produced were defective, and there was nothing I could do about it. This disaster disappointed and demotivated me deeply. I mean, the thought of quitting passed my mind. But hey, I hadn't come this far to give up, so I decided to give it another shot. I traveled to each and every corner of the city to procure the materials. I sometimes carried a 10 kg load of umbrella cloth on my back for 2 kilometers and delivered it to the printer. I took a train that was 2 hours from the city to supervise over the production. And finally, I made quality umbrellas. I mean, just look at these beauties. I thought that after these beauties are there in the market, who would buy a black umbrella? I dreamt about dominating the market. I thought that I'll retire at the age of 24, I'll own a beach in Hawaii, and I'll just chill sipping a margarita. But when I went shop to shop to sell them, I slowly started getting the feel of how the real world works. It's not done by anyone before. We already have good sales with the regular ones. Hey, what is this you have scribbled on this? I'm not going to put money in buying it. This is what most of the retailers said. But there was always this one retailer in each locality who was open to experimentation and he believed in my idea. And that is when I learned the most important lesson of my journey. When you try, you don't fail. The real failure is in not trying at all. Confused? Okay. Let me make a comparison. See, you've got to be realistic. Just like how every girl you like doesn't like you back, not every business meeting can be a successful one. As you may move on from one girlfriend to another, do the same in business as well by focusing on the next sale instead of mourning over the previous failed one. So as the rain gods ascended, my brand Cheeky Chunk was launched. I was so excited. I mean, everyone around me loved my idea. Everyone said it was amazing. Everyone praised it a lot. However, there was just one problem. There were no sales. I mean, I felt like that guy in college who does everything to impress the girl of his life only to get friend-zoned by her. The thing is that I did not have much money. I needed more visibility. I couldn't afford an advertisement in a leading newspaper. So how do I get people to know that I exist? I don't have money, but I have a story. A story about a young entrepreneur trying to turn things around to establish his niche. So, to my delight, a leading daily was happy to publish it. And seeing them, two other dailies published it. And just 2 weeks after this article was out, All my stock was sold out. In the interim, I didn't have a logistics system in place. So to meet with the sudden burst of orders, my intern and I traveled all throughout the cities and buses and trains and delivered each and every umbrella ourselves. And while at it, we got amazingly valuable feedback from our customers, from people who did not even know we existed, from people who paid money out of their pockets just because they believed in my idea. And that is how the most eventful 6 months of my life ended. I got to learn a lot, but I didn't think I make enough money. Everyone around me had a different opinion on what my life was at this point of time. This is what my mom thought I did. This is what my dad thought I did. This is what my friends thought I did. This is what my girlfriend thought I did. And this is what I actually did. What my friends earned in a month or two in their comfortable desk jobs, I earned through slogging, hustling, and giving everything I had in more than half a year. I mean, I was like, why do people judge everyone based on only how much money they have made? So I didn't bother about money. All I knew was that my idea was validated, and this idea had the potential to be big. So I spent all my time on focusing on making new designs. I now focused on e-commerce marketplaces to expand my scope to a national level. And around this time, I came across this beautiful concept, this very new concept. It's called a purple cow. Now, what is a purple cow? If you're driving around a field and you see 100 white cows, you don't bother looking at them. They already exist everywhere. You don't care if they are alive or dead. You just move on with your life. But amongst those 100 white cows, you see this one purple cow, it grabs all your attention. You take a selfie with this cow, you post about it on Instagram, you share it with your friends. It's something that nobody knew existed before. I wanted to be that purple cow. In no time, the most important monsoon of my life was on its way. I had invested everything I had just for this monsoon. I mean, I was so scared that when my first umbrella was listed on Amazon, I asked my dad to make a purchase so that at least there is one sale. And in the days that followed, I literally became like this man with 10 heads. I managed everything from order processing to marketing to inventory management, and I really worked a lot for 20 hours a day. And while at it, I learned about the magic of e-commerce. Everyone, right from a schoolgirl in Bihar to a doctor in Kolkata to a teacher in Kerala, bought our umbrellas. And that is when I realized that just like me, every human being has an innate desire to be different, to stand apart from the crowd, to break the monotony, to be the purple cow. And it is mainly because of this that just 3 weeks after my dad's purchase, my umbrellas were the most sold umbrellas ever on Amazon.in. And in our beloved Prime Minister's words, "Acche din aa gaye." But more than anything else, what brings a smile on my face is to see the smiles on beautiful people when they carry their wonderful umbrellas. I mean, there was this one girl. She didn't know me. When I was having a very bad day of office, I hadn't slept well for days. She randomly called me and she said that, "You know what, Pratik? All my life, I hated the rains. I never went out during the rains because I was too bored and too lazy to carry a boring umbrella. But after buying your umbrella, I wait for it to rain just so that I can flaunt this beautiful umbrella." That is when I realized that I succeeded in my mission. When others thought of just a utility, I imagined a fashion statement, and it worked. The point I'm trying to make over here is that there is no stopping innovation and ingenuity. Don't let anyone ever tell you that you are not good enough to do something. I mean, if this Chhatriwala standing in front of you can tell you his story, you can't imagine what may lie ahead in your life. You don't need to have a big bank balance to be successful in life or to even start a business. You don't need to follow what others are doing. You don't need to build the next big app. All you need to have is this, that turns this into this. Thank you.